So, if I take primary alcohol, ethanol, which is 1 degree alcohol, I've said that 1 degree alcohol will try to form aldehyde, not ketones, okay? And if it is oxidized further using strong oxidizing agent, it will be converted to an carboxylic acid. But here, we are not using any oxidizing agent. We are using a catalyst. So, we are doing catalytic dehydrogenation. We are performing catalytic dehydrogenation. So, this is one method to prepare aldehydes and ketones from alcohols. So, this will be converted to. So, you see there is loss of hydrogen. So, it is dehydrogenation. Since it is taking place in presence of copper at some temperature, it is a catalytic reaction. And for secondary alcohol, if I treat this with copper at the temperature of 573 Kelvin, we will get ketones. Now, so this is secondary alcohol. Now, if I take tertiary alcohol, number 1, this is number 2, number 3, if we take tertiary alcohol, if I treat this, since we are doing dehydrogenation, removal of hydrogen, what will happen is that alkenes will be formed. No aldehyde, no ketones. So it will directly form alkenes. Basically, it is a dehydration reaction that will take place. This is what will form. So this is how we can convert an alcohol to aldehyde, ketones and acids. One more reaction where another functional group can be achieved from alcohol, and that is ether. Ether is another functional group which can be obtained from alcohols. So let's see how we can obtain ether from alcohols. Now, from ether, I can get alcohol. How? This is methoxymethane. The name of this compound is methoxymethane. Now, if I treat this with hydrogen iodide, with an halogen acid, this will produce one alcohol and one alkyl halide. So we can achieve alcohol from ether. We can also get ether from alcohol. Before that, we need to know something about alcohol, and that is the acidic nature or character of this alcohol. Sometimes this alcohol is slightly acidic in nature due to this hydrogen. So, this hydrogen can be released, and this can give rise to protons, and methoxide ion is formed. So, this hydrogen in alcohol is acidic in nature, but it is less acidic than that of water. So, if we compare the acidic character of an alcohol and water, water will be more acidic than that of alcohol. Why? Because in case of water, this will be OH minus H plus. Now, you see, these are the conjugate base, right? If we compare by conjugate base, in case of methoxide ion, the conjugate base is strong. This is strong, and unstable. When a conjugate base is strong and unstable, the corresponding acid will be weak acid. So, weak acid forms conjugate base, strong acid forms weak conjugate base. So, this is the thing. So, strong acid, weak conjugate base and vice versa. Strong acid will produce weak conjugate base, weak acid produces strong conjugate base. In this case, this is a strong conjugate base and also unstable. It must be unstable as well. The conjugate base must be unstable to be weak. Okay? And if it is strong, that means the base is unstable. And if it is a weak, strong conjugate base, that means that base is somehow stabilized, either by resonance or by hyperconjugation or inductivity. So this is the concept of acid base. Now you see, in case of methoxide ion, this is a strong conjugate base because methyl has a plus I effect. Methyl has plus inductive effect, positive inductive effect. So it donates its electron towards this oxygen atom. So it pushes electrons. So increasing the electron density on the oxygen atom. Thus, its availability of electron increases, thus becoming a very good base. So it is a strong conjugate base. And why it is unstable conjugate base? Because this is a plus I effect. So this methyl has plus I effect. It is pushing the electron, increasing the electron density on the oxygen atom instead of delocalizing the negative charge. If the negative charge is delocalized or neutralized, then that is stable. If not so, then that is unstable base. So this is unstable. Since the electron density, instead of getting stabilized or instead of getting delocalized, it is increasing due to the plus I effect of methyl group. So this is unstable base. So corresponding acid will be weak acid. In comparison to water, you see, it has no such methyl groups or any alkyl groups which will exert any plus I effect. So its conjugate base is not so strong. So its corresponding acid is strong acid because its conjugate base is weak. So the corresponding acid will be strong acid. Clear? So if we compare the acidic character of alcohol and water, water is more acidic than that of alcohol. And if we compare the acidic character of all the degrees of alcohol, suppose primary, secondary, tertiary. So more the alkyl groups, less will be its acidity. So methyl alcohol will be more acidic than that of this one, secondary alcohol, like this. So this is weaker acid than this methyl alcohol. So this is how we compare the acidic character of an alcohol. So from here we can deduce that alcohol is slightly acidic, or it has weak acidic character. So if it has weak acidic character, it can react with a metal. So it can react with sodium, where this hydrogen will be replaced by sodium, giving rise to hydrogen gas. So let's see. So methyl group having this acidic hydrogen, when reacts with sodium, give rise to sodium methoxide, and hydrogen is liberated. Like all the acids that similar typical properties of an acid. So if an acid, when treated with a metal, it forms salt and hydrogen is liberated, right? This is called sodium methoxide. Now, treating this sodium methoxide, an ether. So see how we are getting an ether from alcohol due to the acidic hydrogen that this alcohol possesses, where it forms sodium methoxide. When treating with an alkyl halide and heating it, we get an ether. So you see how we are completing or learning all the conversions which involves all the functional groups, starting from alkanes till ethers. So if I draw the concept map of an alcohol,